to thank you all for coming to the George Washington University Vietnamese Student Association production of Crowning Achievements. At this time, please turn off your cell phones, and if there is a need to make an emergency exit, there are doors in the back of the room. So, without further ado, enjoy the show. Thank you.
Thank you. thinking, falling asleep at the desk like that? How do you think that makes me look?
I'm sorry, I already said it a million times. How many more times do I have to apologize? I promise it won't happen again.
No more apologies. Just do your job properly next time. By the way, I talked to the Huangs the other night. You're gonna go on a date with their son this weekend.
Who? Brendan? Isn't he like 5 years older than me and completely arrogant?
The last time you saw him, you were only 8 years old. Besides, I think this could be the one. He's studying to become a surgeon, you know. And from what I hear, he's top of his class. He's only 2 years old.
Why do you keep setting me up on these dates? You know they lead nowhere. Stop trying to marry me out to the highest bidder.
You need security. The sooner you settle down and marry, the better. That is the role of a woman in this life.
Not here. I told you, there really is no guarantee of security after getting married early. This isn't Vietnam where getting married young is a necessity.
You're simply too young to understand what's best for you. I know what you should do and you're going. That's final. I wonder what's in the mail today. Angela? Did you sign up for some kind of pageant?
What? No, I totally forgot about it. That was so long ago.
Why would you spend this ridiculous amount of money on the registration fee for some useless contest?
It's a small price to pay for a chance at the big scholarship. I knew you would react this way, that's why I didn't tell you. Money's tight and college fees are gonna be a burden.
Of course money is tight, but there are always ways around that. You know, your father and I have not worked this hard for nothing, and it wouldn't be such a problem if you would just stay home. I don't know why you wanna go to University of, why you wanna go to Columbia when you could go to University of Washington right here in Seattle. And oh, if you wanna go somewhere, at least go to California. You don't have to pay for a dorm, like go Lian.
No, no UC schools. I'm definitely not going to a UC school. Plus, it's too late. I didn't even apply. Look, if I win, this is gonna help us out a lot. If I don't, I'll make a lot of connections in the Vietnamese community. And that's something you've always wanted, right? I don't see any downsides to this.
Other than wasting time, wasting money, and exploiting yourself, you're not doing this.
Why should I listen to you?
Because I'm your mother, you live under my roof, and I say so.
Yeah, you know what? It's already decided. I'm doing the pageant. So unfair! No, this is not fair. This is unjust. Why does everyone always do whatever they want around here except for me? I'm just gonna do everything in her power to make sure I don't enter the pageant too. It's like the slumber party of 06 all over again.
Hello?
I hate my life.
Tell me something I don't know. What did they do this time?
The usual. My mother's trying to control every aspect of my life. Set me up on another blind date.
How many oxen are they offering for your hands in marriage?
No amount of bags of rice or oxen can impress me. True fact.
God, you're too good for that. But hey, guess what? I got my letter from NYU today. It's official. I'm going to college.
Oh my God, congratulations. I'm so proud of you.
Thanks. Did you go back from Columbia yet?
No. I mean, I've been checking the mail every single day, but still nothing. I called them and they said they couldn't even do anything for me because they don't post the results online. So I'm stuck waiting for a stupid hard copy, but you know what did come in the mail today?
What?
Notification from Miss Vietnam Seattle.
No way. That's amazing. Congrats.
Thanks. I don't really know what to do. I didn't think I would actually get in.
If what you do is walk into that pageant and kick some ass, think about our future. Our dream of moving to New York together. We're best friends and we haven't seen each other since I moved. And that was 10 years ago. Jeez, what is time?
No one wants that to come true more than I do, trust me, but it's all way too much pressure. need to take my mind off things for a while.
So, are you going to do the thing?
The thing?
No, the thing.
You're gonna have to clarify because I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, I can't say what the thing is on the phone, silly. The NSA is listening.
God, this again.
The government is infringing our fundamental rights by surveilling our every move. They have spies everywhere, so we can't be too careful about what we say. I'm your best friend, and as your friend, I don't want to be the one to out you when you're hobbling.
This is the worst of the time you're obsessed with the Illuminati. And don't worry, I don't think the government's cracking down on graffiti artists.
Shh, no, don't say that. Call it Thing. That's his code name.
Why does it have to be called a Thing? That's lame, even for you.
Layla doesn't stand out too much. I think it's perfect.
Sure, whatever.
So, you didn't answer my question. Are you going to do the thing?
You know what? I think I will.
What are you doing here?
I could ask you the same question. Although you could be an undercover cop for all I know.
Would an undercover cop really be painting a skate park and then a bike?
I did say undercover cop.
Look, if you're trying to sell me drugs, I'm not interested.
Please. I'm not here to sell drugs. To you. But seriously, I'm not here to sell drugs. Although, if I was, it doesn't look like you're in any position to alert the authorities.
Well, could you at least go somewhere else? Kind of isn't.
Let me guess. You're a sheltered suburban child. You might have seen a clip from Exit Through the Gift Shop once or twice and thought, graffiti's cool. They can do it. Why can't I? As a result, you splash a little paint here and there, rebel against your parents who understand nothing about you. You're so much more than the golden egg stereotype. And to prove it, you're going out and doing something risky, otherwise dull and unsuccessful.
All right. Well, as long as we're firing shots, what about you? Let me guess, you're a high school dropout with no career prospects or intention to continue your education. You have nothing better to do than loiter in alleyways and smoke weed in public after your shift at Yoshishi Pizza Factories. And when you're feeling up to it, you'll occasionally tag walls and cards with, clumsily drawn genitalia as your way of sticking it to the man.
Wow. Wow. Nailed it, actually. Though people don't usually get my interest in clumsy genitalia.
Buzz off, okay?
No, that's not bad. I like your remark on American consumerism. Your technique could use some work, but I like your style.
I'm not exactly sure I should be taking criticism from you.
Listen, I definitely have more knowledge and experience on this, my friend.
I'm not your friend.
I'm just saying, there's a lot of amateur scribbles around here. Can you make your work stand out?
I like to think that all my pieces have their own integrity. I don't need to add any bells or whistles to make them stand out.
Okay. Those are big words for someone who looks like they picked up a piano a week ago.
Well, if you're so good, I'm sure you wouldn't mind telling me about what you've done.
Other than clumsy genitalia? I have a lot of work around town. You've probably not only seen it, but gazed upon it with admiration, hoping to get all mopped up.
First off, no one says that anymore. And second, I'll believe you when you can prove you're Seattle's king of street art. Right now you're more like the Orchester.
I'm honored to at least be on the court.
You have anything around here?
Please. Any of my work's probably covered in a million layers of paint by now. The real artists won't even touch this place.
This is not a real artist.
Not me. I meant it when I said I like your style. And with some work, it would be really good.
Thanks.
I guess I should. Mark.
Andrew.
So you look kind of familiar. seen you around here before?
You know, I must have one of those faces. Agent.
Must be one of your first tags.
Yeah. This is like my second one. It takes forever to plan these out. I don't really have nights where I can sneak out and do this anymore.
Oh yeah, must be tough with such strict parents.
How do you know I have strict parents?
Or the fact that you have to sneak out to do something you enjoy.
Yeah, they annoy me a lot, especially recently.
Why don't you tell me about it?
It's really stupid.
Well, I like to make an effort. Shut up. I know you want to talk about it. Talk.
Long story short, my parents are going to marry me off if I don't raise enough money to go to college in New York. That is, if I even get it. Regardless, totally against my decision to enter a pageant to win some scholarship.
Pageant? Seriously?
What's that supposed to be?
Nothing. I just wouldn't take you as a pageant girl.
Are you calling me ugly?
No. Calm down.
Oh, don't tell me to calm down. I hate that.
Okay. Please. All right. So, with your strap for cash, why not compromise? Go to closer school, UCLA. You know, Disneyland's near there.
Everyone always brings that up, but no UC schools. I'm never going to go to UC school. Draw a phallus on this, but just don't.
Nice to meet you too.
Mid-20s, early 30s, but...
have to go to work.
Can you skip one day? I mean, if you're this stressed, why don't you come grab the lot of books?
I can't. I have to go to work and I have to study for this test. I'm sorry.
Fine. Just say you don't love us and move on. We'll see you tomorrow.
Guys, wait!
Hello? Hi. Yeah, no, I can't come into work today. I have to study for that test. Yeah, I'll see you at home after work. Okay, bye. Yeah. Bye. 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 No, seriously. Bye. Bye. There are three things guaranteed in this life: death, taxes, and my mother being a huge. Hi! I was just wondering if we're still meeting up in an hour? Great. Alright, I'll see you then. Bye.
Secondary to how you present your mind and your attitude. Those are great.
I'm on my way home.
You better be. It's getting late.
Yeah, I know, I know. I'm on my way. Okay, bye. Sorry, I have to go. I've been embarrassingly earlier.
Don't worry about it. I understand.
But thank you so much for meeting with me today. I really appreciate it.
Of course, we should do this again sometime.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Thank you.
See you.
Thank you.
Spinaching ahead of the problem.
No,
no! Okay.
Okay. Okay. So, how's school today?
Fine. I got a drunk high and pregnant as usual.
It's not funny, Angela. You should take your education as a joke. Latecomers so that you could slack off and become a title.
No, sorry. I was just joking around. How's work?
Oh, it's all right. Busier than usual because spring break's coming up. You know what? There was this one girl who came in, though. She was talking about that pageant you were in. She's been by many times before.
So what's for dinner? Yeah, I have a huge test study for her tomorrow,
she's
so I'm just gonna go
decent, take it. I guess, but she dropped out of college against her parents' wishes. Don't you think?
In some cases, yeah. So was a boss. Was he too upset at my absence?
He was fine. You know, she was saying that she was going to help some girl with the pageant. Oh. Maybe she could help you too.
Yeah, I'll totally talk to her the next time she comes in.
You will?
Yeah.
You know what else was interesting?
What?
The girl she's helping out is conveniently the receptionist at our nail salon. Do you know anything about that?
Mom, I can explain.
Explain? Explain what? How you lied to me? How you kept your meeting with Tiffany? I thought we were over this. You're not doing this pageant.
I was just going to ask her a few questions. I was going to tell you, but you wouldn't have let me go.
Of course I wouldn't have let you go. You see that you have no time and this and that, but you have time for this pageant? What about some time to help me cook, huh? Or help me around the house? You see that you have a big test tomorrow? That should be your priority. Not this silly contest. Your father and I have worked so hard so that you and your sister could have a good life, and this is how you repay me? By keeping secrets from me?
Man, what's with all the shouting? Is everything okay?
Everything's fine. Why are you all dressed up?
Oh, I forgot to tell you. I'm going out for a little bit tonight. It's Lori's birthday, so I promise I'll be back before 11.
Lori? Alright, did you do all your homework?
Yes, ma'am, I have.
Be home by 10, not 11. It's a school night.
Okay, thanks, Mom. Bye.
Bye.
You're letting her go out on a school night just like that? You never let me leave without interrogating me
first. She keeps me updated. You, on the other hand, just go to your room and stay in your computer. You never talk to me.
That's because I'm studying. I'm doing exactly as you asked. You want me to do it well in school, and now you say I study too much? I don't know what you want from me.
All I want from you is to forget about this pageant and focus on getting into University of Washington.
Only want me to stay here so you can set me up. And I understand it's tradition, but I can't even think about marriage right now.
You don't have to think about it. I'm handling it for you. Don't you know? This is what's best for you.
I'm an adult now, okay? I can make my own decisions. And I know I might not know everything, but I know what I want and how I can get it. Right now, I want to go to Columbia. I want to be a lawyer. And I want to live my own life and make my own decisions.
But that might be your man, huh? If you say that you're an adult now, then let's make a deal right here. If you win the pageant, you can take the money and do whatever you want.
Okay. If I lose,
then you do the right thing, Angela. You stay home, go to University of Washington, and let me handle your future. No questions asked.
That's crazy. You can't just control every aspect of my life.
You say that you're an adult now, and adults need to make tough decisions. This is why you shouldn't be in such a hurry to grow up. If you want, you can still change your mind.
You know what? No. I'm going to show you I am doing the right thing. You've got yourself a deal.
Thank you.
She looks like it went through a broken pasta roller.
It's not that bad. It's probably good enough for the pageant, right?
Hell no! I'm forbidding you from wearing that on stage. Don't you want to win? Because, Angela, it looks like you don't care at all.
Of course I care. I mean, I'm only doing this because I'm broke. The registration fee practically cleaned me out.
Well, regardless, you're gonna need more than just an old dress from your closet to stand a chance against everyone else.
You're right.
Yeah.
I don't even know where to get them, how was I?
Wait, what? Okay. It's not good. It's not good. Okay. Tell you what. I'll loan you some money. And then you can pay me back later. Okay,
yeah. No, I should work. I couldn't ask you to do that. That's way too much.
It's fine. You're gonna become some big shot lawyer anyway, right? Well, you better earn enough money to be able to pay me back. We're due for a huge shopping trip anyway. It's an essential of pageant training. Basically, you're gonna try on a whole bunch of dresses, and I'm gonna shake my head at every single one of them until I find the one that I like.
You mean like a movie montage?
I mean, I was thinking more of a training montage, actually.
Tiffany, this isn't a teen movie. You can't do a montage in real life.
Are you sure about that?
Morty, jumping jack, now!
Hi!
Let's go! What are you doing? Lift your legs up high! You look-
I have a limited range of motion!
You look like a giant star!
I got an injury! Like football, it's a long story!
If I can do this in heels, you can do this in whatever you
want!
Your floor is so
perfect.
Dirty!
My room is always perfect, like me! I mean, what?
Okay, have you seen me? I am perfect, not you. Clean the floor. You're missing a spot! You're missing a spot! You're missing a whole spot! How do you live in
this? I don't know what spot you're talking about, but
have
I love
it! My room is the cleanest room ever! Keep doing what you're doing! I'm still watching you!
Okay, just stop. Just come over here.
She can be a pageant queen. Hear this.
I've been worried sick about you.
Sorry, I was out a little later than usual. I was just training with Tiffany.
Training? Looks like you had a lot of fun shopping to me.
We needed new dresses for the pageant.
What is this? You know I don't approve of these kinds of outfits.
There's nothing wrong with it, and it looks better when I put it on. And I chose it, okay? Not her.
I can't believe I let you go through this training, whatever this is. What has she been teaching you anyways?
Just the basics, how to walk, talk, and dress. I mean, the small things that might make the difference between winning and losing.
Win or lose, that's not the point. She only cares about what you look like and not what you need to do.
How would you know?
Because I've seen her. I know her type. Did you ever consider that you're entering a Vietnamese pageant? Did you ever think about the extra steps you need to take to win?
Of course. I even bought an Azai.
Azai, John? We have plenty of traditional ones back home. Why would you buy an Azai? What is this? I don't approve of this.
Okay, it's a modern Azai. It's what everyone else is wearing these days.
It's an abomination to Azai. You need to stick to tradition, Angela. That's what the judges will like.
Okay, wearing a boring traditional dress won't guarantee that I'll win.
If you reject tradition, then you reject your history. Do you think the judges will like some girl whose blood is Vietnamese but her mind is completely whitewashed? It's not enough to say that you're Vietnamese when you can barely say a sentence in your native language. The winner of this pageant needs to make people proud to be Vietnamese, and what you're doing, it's not enough. Well, I don't approve of this entire thing. I can't have you parading around with that girl and embarrassing our family. Forget everything that she's taught you. Being from your generation, she doesn't know what the judge is like. I will help you from now on. And you're returning those dresses tomorrow.
So I'm studying engineering at the University of Washington, minor in graphic design. That was kind of random, but anyways, if you're gonna be a lawyer, why aren't you like studying or something?
I have to do other things besides study. Besides, I like making art. My parents might think it's a stupid hobby, but I don't know. It's the only other thing besides academics that I'm remotely proficient at.
Proficient, yeah. It's a good word for whatever that is.
I'm just gonna remind you, you can leave it any time.
By the way, I mean to ask you, where are you from?
Seattle.
No, I mean like, where are you from?
You must know, I burst forth from my mother's loins at Seattle Children's Hospital.
You know what I mean.
Okay, I'll humor you. Both of my parents were born and raised in Vietnam, and they fled to America. I had the great misfortune of being born in the darkest, most boring state of all time. But at least it's better than living in a fishing boat than whatever.
So, do you speak Vietnamese?
At a very basic level, yeah.
Oh, can you say something?
I hate when people ask me that.
Why?
Well, that's a great way to make somebody feel really awkward and uncomfortable. Plus, I never know what to say.
Yeah, you should have like a stock sentence or something. Like, the dog went to the store. Or, your mama's so fat, she sits on both sides of the family. 4,000 deaf people. But I digress. You should be proud to speak another language. It's like a party trick that never gets old.
It's not about pride or shame. Vietnamese most of the time. Sure, I say I'm Vietnamese out of habit, but really I'm just me and nothing else. I just hate how I have to always be geographically identified before someone gets to know me, you know? I feel like I've spent my entire life not even knowing much about my own culture. I mean, my parents rarely ever talked about it growing up, and I was never interested. I guess I actively dismissed it. I never wanted to seem too weird or different. I never wanted to stick out too much, you know? You're judging me, aren't you?
No, actually, I know where you're coming from. Yeah. I was actually adopted. It feels weird saying I'm from Pakistan when I don't speak Urdu and I can't remember my time there. I mean, my favorite food's fried chicken. And I go on yearly camping trips to Colorado. There's no room to be Pakistani in my family. My parents, they're the best. They'll never understand where I'm from. And even if they did, they wouldn't have the same connection as I do. But I can. It's isolating and no one wants to feel that way.
Yeah, but for me, I guess it's a different kind of isolation. Parents and I rarely ever talk, and when we do, it's about something mundane or it's just another argument. You know, I don't even know enough Vietnamese to connect with them on a deeper level, and I'm tired of being ashamed of how little I do know. I mean, can I really say I'm Vietnamese if I don't know what it's like to live in a world with stories behind it? It's about so much more than just speaking the language and eating the food and watching Paris by night. At heart as well. That connection, whatever it is, has been missing in my life.
Well, maybe this passion will be the experience that you need. In fact, after it, you'll have plenty of time for the rest of your life to work towards that connection you've always wanted.
It's a lot easier said than done.
Yes, it is, but if you want something, it's up to you to make it happen.
Right. I can't dwell on the negatives.
You'll find it. Don't worry.
Thanks.
It'll all work.
Yeah, so I actually have to go because I have a...
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna go.
Time went to Disneyland. I stood in front of the animation studio for like half an hour. I was so mesmerized by the drawings, they had to pull me away. Well, turns out I have an animation internship, and I applied. I know what you'd say, animation, artsy stuff, to put food on the table, let's pay the bills. I've come a long way these past few years. I could really make something of myself with art. I wish I had my whole life planned out like Angela does. You don't know about her. Yeah, I met a girl the other day at the park visit this long time. God, man, you liked her a lot. She's smart, interesting, and I don't know. She kind of reminds me of you guys around. She's been trying to escape her culture basically her entire life. I don't understand that at all. You guys are still here? Even at this age, I still want to spend time with you. Especially because I can't. If you were still here, fight all the time? Would I be like Angelo? About what you want for me? What I want for myself? Would I find it hard to face my culture? Our culture? Because I'm slowly forgetting it. I don't know. I can't let that happen though. It was so important to you, culture and things like that. Maybe I'll go back to Pakistan. It'll all come back to me. Maybe instead of art, I'll grow to love engineering. Maybe. You know what? No. Art, engineering, embracing my culture or abandoning it, they're just obstacles. A couple of many that I could face without your wisdom, Abba. Your grace. It'll be difficult. I can do it. It's on me to make it happen.
One more day, it's almost over.
You can do this.
fine, okay? Plus, you're being trained by me. Which is great. Which, by the way, at least make an effort to remember your training. Never runs down, okay? The floor is under your feet. It's not going anywhere. Always keep your chin parallel to the ground. And remember, walk like a robot. So it's kind of natural.
Angela, quiet loud! When are you finished?
I'm sorry, Tiffany was just giving me some last minute tips.
Tips? What have you been telling her?
Just that she needs to look up, not down, that she needs to glide. Now, as I was saying, you need to...
Angela, how can you not look at the ground? You won't know where you're going. And glide? She's not a bird. Look down every once in a while so that you don't fall. And stop smiling so much. The judge is like someone who's serious about their competition and heritage.
All due respect, I've been doing this for a long time now, and if Angela was to win, then she should listen to me. Angela, this is a beauty pageant, so never, ever look down. Okay, always look up, always. And please, smile. The judges want to see you having fun, embracing your heritage. Okay, and as for your diet, remember to get in those carbs and stay hydrated. Stay awake. Stay away from foods that are high in fat. If it's anything that won't sit well in your stomach, do not eat it. Also, I'll bring you some fruits, especially bananas.
Do it! You cannot eat bananas tomorrow. If you eat bananas, you'll lose.
Excuse me?
If you eat bananas, then you'll slip out of window. Don't you know? If you want to win, you have to eat beans tonight.
Beans? You know, I don't mind walking needs a little work, but I don't think gliding across the stage because of all the gas in my stomach is going to impress the judges.
Ha! What are you even saying?
Your grandmother fed me so many beans before a big test. If you eat beans, then you'll place. And no.
No, 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 no.
If you want a shot at the title, then you should listen to me. Remember to work on what we talked about? Get a lot of sleep, okay? We don't need extra makeup to cover your back. See you tomorrow?
Yeah.
Oh, and Angela? I'll still be bringing you fruit.
Get calm, Nick. When this pageant is over, I don't want you hanging out with her anymore. She's talking back to her elders like that. And hurry up, I want to go home.
Don't have to worry about that. I'll be making new friends in New York.
It's just a phase. Sooner or later, she'll grow out of it and she'll start talking to you again.
She's so worked up about this pageant when she should be worried about her future. Can't she just realize what I'm doing is what's best for her?
She'll never know that until she goes through parenthood herself. And plus, even if we'd never admit this to our children, we were just like them as teenagers.
I am sure we weren't as rebellious or disrespectful.
Remember that time we wanted to go to Saigon with all of our friends, but Mom and Dad wouldn't let us? Why we wanted to go, I don't even remember. But Mom was especially mad about you asking to go all the time. After that, we were just so angry at them for not understanding what we wanted and not listening to us when we said that it'd be safe.
I think I didn't talk to Mom for a week after that.
Yeah, me too. Ugh, But a few weeks later, we heard about the riots that happened there, the exact day we were planning to go. Boy, you sure ate a war time.
You know, that was the only rash decision I made as a teenager.
Oh, really? You've made plenty of rash decisions. You just don't remember. And it's a difficult age for anyone, no matter where they're from or how privileged they are. Angela may not understand why you're doing these things for her, but she'll come around.
If she would just let me be a part of her life, I could protect her from all the things that would go wrong. I just don't want her to get hurt, Ike.
Listen, the trouble with being parents is that we always think we can predict all the things that can go wrong in their lives. That's something that will never change. But she has to make her own mistakes to be strong and independent, right? Now, I'm not saying to let her go out and do whatever she wants, but she's old enough to know what's right from wrong. Have faith in the way you raised her. And you know that she's a good kid. One day, she'll look back and she'll know that you raised her right. And hopefully, we'll raise her own children somewhere.
I hope it happens sooner rather than later.
She's still as impatient as ever. Some things never change.
Angela's pageant tomorrow. I sure hope. I can't wait for this to be over.
Well, best of luck to her and to you for everything else.
Gamma and Nani, I really do appreciate that. I'll be leaving first then.
Okay. Bye. Guess the check is mine. Again.
I'll drown. I'm so sorry.
scared I'm gonna be stuck in the sinkhole of a town forever.
Sinkhole? That's a good one. I'm gonna use that from now on.
The other day I saw the other contestants and everyone was really in their element, like they'd both done this before. One girl was even talking to one of the judges in Vietnamese, and no doubt she was sucking up, but it was really impressive.
Don't worry. You'll do fine. You practiced so much for this.
What for all just a waste?
Then there'll be chances to do something else.
There might not be another chance. Seriously, Mark, if I lose, this isn't the end of it. I'm gonna be stuck here in this town, commuting to a school that I hate, getting married when I'm 20, all because my mom couldn't change the traditional lifestyle that she wanted for me. I mean, what if I can't do it? She shouldn't have made that stupid bargain with her in the first place.
So, what? Are you giving up? Are you admitting defeat?
Of course not. It's just, if I lose, what am I gonna do?
Alright, listen up, man. I'm only gonna say this once.
Ange?
Sure, you may be cold, harsh, selfish, temperamental, stubborn, a little uptight, cynical. You talk too much, you have one track mind, you overthink things.
Thank you, I feel a lot better about myself.
But you're also smart, hardworking, and headstrong. I admire that. Not to mention, not a lot of people know exactly what they want in life. And I hate to admit it, but you're actually a really good painter. Hilarious. Kind when you want to be. And beautiful.
Oh.
You worked so hard for this pack, worrying about some self-doubt.
Yeah.
Don't invest a lot of time and energy into this. Don't throw it all away because you think you might lose. I want to win. Act like that. But if you do sink, everyone who cares about you, me included, be there to save you. I promise.
Angela, did you say something?
God, no! Get out!
Wait, is somebody in there?
No, I'm just watching a movie!
We'll be right back. Seattle pageant. First of all, let's give one more round of applause to all our brilliant band dancers. My name is Andrew Pizzazz, and I shall be your host this evening. We've got a fantastic show in store for you tonight. The Miss Vietnam Seattle Selection Committee has carefully chosen 8 lovely ladies to compete for the coveted crown and a title of Miss Vietnam Seattle 2014. So, without further ado, let's bring them out, shall we? First up, it is her endless passion for courting cop shows that's inspired her to one day strive to become a criminal justice lawyer. Please welcome Melody Tom.
Hi everyone, I'm a ballet dancer that'll dance circles around the competition.
Up next, she's got a smile as bright as the name that describes her. Please give it up for Crystal Pham.
Hi everyone, I'm just a girl who loves to have fun.
Well then. Up next, she's currently trying to decide whether she should go to college or pursue dancing as a career. Please welcome Victoria Wen.
I'm a passionate dancer who can't cook for her life.
And up next, oh good lord, this is a long one. She works in the soup kitchen in her spare time, has started 2 charities, and is also a foster parent for sheltered dogs. Please welcome Trang Go.
Oh, I'm just average.
Up next, she is currently studying feline biology at the University of Phoenix. Please welcome Ansu.
I prefer to be cautious with male.
Good lord. Up next, you may recognize her, in fact, from her numerous appearances in various shampoo commercials. Please welcome Miss Genevieve Bui.
Hi, everyone.
Well then, up next, she is currently a senior in high school trying to decide between going to Georgetown or George Washington University. And she's going to pick GW because, well, what's a Hoya anyway? Please give it up for Lin Wen.
I'm a passionate poet who loves to cook.
And last but not least, we've got a contestant with both beauty and brain playing the game. Please give it up for Miss Angela Tran.
It's an honor to be here, and I hope you all enjoy the show.
And there you have it, folks. Please give one more round of applause to all our lovely contestants. Now, we're going to begin the evening with the good old-fashioned Ozai fashion show. Ozai, true to the literal translation, are long silk dresses worn mainly by Vietnamese women. It is the ultimate symbol of Vietnamese beauty, grace, and tradition. The judges will be evaluating each of the contestants based on their grace, their overall presence on the stage, the design of the Ozai, and of course, her overall confidence. It is important to remain confident at all times because...
Places, ladies!
She must also possess an expert skill. And so enough of that, all of the show.
I know of you is all the sights of war. To be awake before its lights can even penetrate the horizons as to fight the birds for their worms. I take extra precaution in hopscotching over the cracked pavements as to spare the spine of my beloved mother. And I carry a small block of wood in my pocket that is hastily summoned whenever I feel the need to unjinx myself. And so, it may not be a surprise to you when I say, as cliche as this may sound, that my life has been a perpetual marathon. A constant race towards a finish line that only seems to grow more distant with every step that I take. Running seems to be a tradition within my family, a curse passed from mother to child like hand-me-down shoes that continues to build character with the mark of each new stain, but whose soles only continue to wear away with each generation. My mother was ironically forced to run away from her motherland. A newly hatched bird being prematurely pushed out of its nest before it's given the opportunity to be nourished by the being that birthed it. With the clothes on her back and her 2 feet, she ran. While her destination was not predetermined, she just kept on running, for hours, for days, sometimes in solitude, but mostly with strangers, who acted as her makeshift family, concealing their identities from their enemies. Their escape was imminent. As long as the earth was forced to move underneath the friction of their feet. My mother ran for freedom. She ran to keep hope alive for her family. So for whom do I run? I can sincerely say that up until recently, it's been for you, Mom. Your happiness, our family's happiness. I honestly only strive to please you. It's something that they don't teach you. That in the end, you're responsible for your own life, that you're responsible for your own happiness, and that by being the best at school, being the best at classes, never added up to the fulfillment that I so desperately searched for. So is it okay for me to be selfish? To live for myself when I have lived my life so far for others? You ran for freedom, Mother, but I run for freedom too. A different type of freedom. I came out to my mom in the winter of last year. I cried because I didn't know what she would think of me, and I cried because I didn't want her to not love me. And as I waited for her response, the silence weighed down on the emptiness of the room. We both held our breaths as to spare each other from what we wanted to say. And I don't know if you know how much it hurt me, Mom, when you said nothing. It's been a continuous process. We don't talk about it in my family. Because it's not tradition, we never learned about it. I was ashamed of it and I tried so hard to change, but I'm tired of running this constant uphill battle. A lot of this ties in with me not feeling like I was good enough, that this was not what I'm supposed to be. I'm not supposed to be bad at anything. But I've come to realize that this concept of fighting to be better than I already am is no longer a negativity. That by being happy with where you are and then striving to be better than that will set you free. So I'll pick up the shoes that you gave me, and I will wipe off the salty tears that have imprinted themselves onto their exteriors. I'll gladly wear them and start my journey over, this time running downhill.
now, we move on to the final segment of our competition, the Q&A section. First up, Hansu. If you had the power to instantly change one thing about society, what would you change?
Well, I'm very passionate about cats and politics. So right now I'm lobbying for cat rights to be added to the Constitution so that in 2016, they might be able to vote for the next American president.
Lovely. Lynn, step forward, please. Now, what can you do to help the Vietnamese community?
First off, thank you for the question. I think that the most important part about being in the Vietnamese community is to help others. We need to educate ourselves and each other in order to help each other as effectively as we can. We can also participate in local community service programs in order to help those in need, especially in the wake of natural disasters. And of course, I will get everybody else to pitch in as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Lynn. Finally, Ms. Angela. All right. As a Vietnamese American, how important is your heritage to you?
Crap! I spent so much time trying to look like a pageant queen that I totally liked what this call was actually about.
Remember, if you want something, it's on you to make it happen.
Remember why you entered in the first place? You wanted to put yourself out there. But you're here now. Don't overthink it. Just let go of everything. Just be yourself. All the judges are looking for you. Oh, and Angela? Don't grimace.
Angela, I know you may not understand now, but someday you'll realize how important your heritage is. Do you remember the story of how your father and I got here? We were stranded at sea for 3 days with nothing to eat, packed like sardines. It took us forever to get to the Philippines, and when we were finally at the refugee camp, we had to work hard and study every day. 3 whole years until we finally made it to America. Being Vietnamese is not about wearing áo dài or celebrating date every year, or even speaking the language fluently. It's also important to remember the strength of our people, the hardships and obstacles we overcame to be where we are today. You can say that you're Vietnamese, but to be truly Vietnamese, you have to feel it in your heart.
Thank you for that question. My Vietnamese heritage is important to me, not only as a Vietnamese American, but as a person overall. I couldn't even imagine my life without a Vietnamese influence. Our rich culture and history has helped shape who I am, as well as many of those just like me who have been raised away from our homeland. No. I don't know the pain and sadness of living in war. I don't know what it's like to live in poverty. But I understand the strength of our people and the spirit that keeps our culture alive. I'm proud to be Vietnamese inside and out, and I wouldn't change a thing. Thank you.
And that concludes our final section. The judges will now convene to determine this year's Miss Vietnam Seattle. We'll be taking a short break, but do not go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Hey.
eat a burger and take off these frickin' heels. Oh my god. Look like a melting, colorful cake.
One of these three beautiful ladies is about to be crowned Miss Vietnam Seattle. I've got the results right here. But before I get to that, I'd like to take a moment to thank our lovely sponsor at Far 495 for your lovely support. It was a pleasure doing business with you. We love you. And now, the winner of this year's Miss Vietnam Seattle is... Congratulations, Lynn! You are this year's Miss Vietnam Seattle! Yay. I can take this one a little bit. Thank the boys from the studios. Thank the boys in the back. Thank you. Drive safe.
Where I was before, but I'm not alone. Project. You know, I'm his favorite intern after all. And when I'm looking over the papers he's handed me, there are so many mistakes, like none of the numbers made any sense. I had no idea what was going on.
How did you know there were even mistakes? Aren't you like a junior in college?
You're so naive.
You mean naive, right?
Whatever. Anyways, oh, that's right, I'm on a Wash U's lacrosse team. I've taken loads of business and econ courses, so, you know, I kind of know what I'm talking about.
Wait, what? I might be taking some of the same business classes as you. What's the highest level econ course you've taken?
I think it was, like, Econ 101. But my professor was really invested, and of course, I was a fair student.
Aren't those econ classes, like, or intro classes, filled with, like, hundreds of students?
You know, he's such a cute little freshman. So in college, professors have these office hours where you go in and
I know what office hours are.
Okay, rude. Anyways, I go into my professor's office hours and we start talking about lacrosse. Turns out he's a total lax bro. Oh my god, best professor ever. He even came to some of my games, bumped me up from a C+ to a B-.
Amazing, a B-.
Right. Let's take this real quick. Gotta take a pic, you know. You can just take a picture.
Am I in this?
Oh, it's a selfie. No, I don't want that. Perfect. Alright. Yeah, that's good. I'm good. I guess then that's all my lax bros. Oh, you can have this bag now.
Thanks. So, lacrosse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm on Wash U's lacrosse team.
Oh, you go to school in Missouri? Hey,
shut up for a second. Oh, don't worry about it. Never mind. That was my younger brother, Jenny. I mean, Victor. Victor, my younger brother, Victor. Successful asshole. Oh, yeah, that's right. He's dating this one Filipino or something, nurse. Her name's Jocelyn. Oh, total babe. 10 out of 10, wood bang. So fast. Oh, right. What were we talking about? Oh, right, lacrosse. Now I go to a Washington State University. Call it Wash U. People get it mixed up all the time.
Are you on the varsity team? You must travel.
No. I would be on varsity, but it's such a huge time commitment. And, you know, taking so many challenging courses, like, I don't have time for it. Sorry. Yeah, that's how it is. What time is it?
It's almost 10.
Yeah, you need to go now. I need to meet someone else.
Oh, yeah. Okay, it's not like I was hungry
either. Oh, did you say something?
No, I was just saying we should probably get going too.
Yeah, we need to go. Check! So, are you paying cash or credit?
How is your date? How's Alan doing?
He's great. Well, yes. I'm tired. I'm just
going to bed. Wait, I think we should talk.
Okay.
I have something for you.
It's finally here.
You did. You worked hard to earn it.
Says it was sent out like March 10th. That was about a month ago. Why does it take so long to get here?
Right decision?
Right decision? What right decision? I know we've had plenty of arguments before, but this is taking it way too far. How long have you been behind this for me?
I was only trying to do what was best for you.
How long?
3 weeks. Angela, I know you worked really hard on your college applications and your studies. You've been really strong and independent, and I do appreciate that.
Never said anything about it before.
Well, I really am proud of you.
Seriously?
You don't believe me?
I do. I guess I. You know, you're right. You were always right. Ensuring financial stability is the most important thing, and maybe staying home for college is really for the best. I understand that now.
I still stand by the fact that if you settle down and marry early, you'll be secure. But, you know, you really haven't been the same since the pageant ended, and while parents want to provide their children with security, the most important thing they should provide is happiness. So, with that in mind, your father and I would like for you to go to Columbia.
Seriously? You're letting me go? Even after everything we've been through for the past few weeks? You're really letting me do this? Oh my gosh!
Well, they are conditions though, Angela. You have to keep working at the nail salon.
Yes.
To save up books, save up money to buy books.
Yes,
oh,
yes,
you gotta
yes.
keep looking for scholarships.
Yes,
you'll be all the way
yes.
in the city at New York. It's very expensive living there. You gotta call us every day. Oh, the city is not safe at all. I wouldn't know what's going on with you. You have to tell me how you are if you're alive.
Yeah, I do that.
Oh, and most importantly, if you go through this, you have to work extra hard on your studies. No excuses.
Yes, of course I will. Thank you so much.
As the man before my mind is put the food to be a fool. Your head for the crown of that coalition, cause it will be my mind. Weakness was the tip by mine. By mine.
Hey! I mean, hi.
Hey yourself.
So, guess what? I'm going to Columbia! Oh, my mom hit the acceptance letter and I was really pissed off, but now I don't think I even have the right to be pissed off. But anyways, it's a really long, cheesy story you probably don't want to hear about. But anyways, all you need to know is that I'm going. I'm actually going.
I had a feeling you were going to tell me.
What? How?
You suck at keeping secrets. Especially when it involves exciting news.
I do not. And way to ruin the moment of my big reveal.
Speaking of ruining the moment, when I saw you at the pageant,
why didn't you come up to me after the show?
It didn't seem like the right time, because of what happened.
Well, you could have consoled me in my time of need.
Oh my God, are you doing this right now?
Well, you asked, so I am doing this right now. Why didn't you come up to me and...
I have something to show you. Stop struggling so much.
What are you doing?
Listen, it's a surprise. Relax, please.
This feels insane. You did this for me?
No, I just found it like this. The exact configuration that I wanted to surprise you with. It was set up by Keebler Elves.
Oh,
shut up, Princess. Have a seat. I did this to take your mind off things, but I guess now we're just gonna celebrate.
I hope you brought fireworks.
Yeah, about that.
Some celebration this is.
You know you would.
Thank you, though. Not only for this, but for everything.
Like what, specifically?
You already know, don't make me spell it out for you.
Alright, I guess that's as good as it's going to get, so... Pleasure's been all mine.
Great, so I'm watching.
Oh, you'll see. I hope you enjoy my selection.
Oh no, you're such an asshole.
Thank you. will be a reception at Columbian Square, free finger foods,
but
and mingling with your fellow audience members. So, yes, thank you for coming.